Good morning. It is me, Pastor Reed, again. Now, I met you some week ago. Well, we have our opening hymnal on 203, so you can follow from our organist. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our hail in the name of the Lord. If you, Lord, keep record of sins, O Lord, who could stand? Since we are gathering to hear God's word, call upon Him in prayer and press, and receive body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ in fellowship of this altar. Let us first consider our worldliness and confess before God and one another that we are sinners in thought, word, and deed, and that we cannot free ourselves from our sinful condition. Together as his people, let us take refuge in the infinite mercy of God. Our Heavenly Father, seeking his grace for the sake of Christ, and saying, God be merciful to me as a sinner.
Almighty God, have mercy upon us, forgive us our sins, and lead us to everlasting life.
Amen. Almighty God, in his mercy, has given his Son to die for you and for his sake for forgiveness for you all. You sent us as a called and ordained servant of the Christ, and by his authority, I therefore forgive all your sins in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and the Holy Spirit. I can see it. I can stand. For you have delivered my soul from death, yes, my feet from falling, that I may walk before God in the light of life. When I am hovered, I put my trust in you, in God, whose word I press. In God I trust, I shall not be hovered. What can flesh do to me? In God, whose word press. In the Lord, whose word I press. In God I trust, I shall not be hovered. What can man do to me? Glory to be the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginnings, it is now, and will be forever. Amen. God, because your abiding presence always goes with us, keep us aware of your daily mercies, that we may live secure and content in your eternal love. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who live and reign with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, and now and forever. So we will have our past readings. You have to see.
The Old Testament reading for today is from Jeremiah chapter 20. And Jeremiah is speaking here. O Lord, you have deceived me, and I was deceived. You are stronger than I, and you have prevailed. I have become a laughingstock all the day. Everyone mocks me. For whenever I speak, I cry out, I shout, violence and destruction. For the word of the Lord has become for me a reproach and derision all day long. If I say I will not mention him or speak any more in his name, there is in my heart a burning fire shut up in my bones, and I am weary with holding it in, and I cannot. For I hear many whispering, terror is on every side. Denounce him. Let us denounce him, say all my close friends watching for my fall. Perhaps he will be deceived. Then we will overcome him and take our revenge on him. But the Lord is with me as a dread warrior. Therefore my persecutors will stumble, and they will not overcome me. They will be greatly shamed, for they will not succeed. Their eternal dishonor will never be forgotten. O Lord of hosts, who tests the righteous, who sees the heart and the mind, let me see your vengeance upon them. For to you I have committed my cause. Sing to the Lord, praise to the Lord. For he has delivered the life of the needy from the hands of the evildoers. This is the word of the Lord.
God.
The epistle reading is from Romans chapter 6. Let not sin, therefore, reign in your mortal bodies to make you obey their passions. Do not present your members to sin as instruments for unrighteousness, but present yourselves to God as those who have been brought from death, and your members to God as instruments for righteousness. For sin will have no dominion over you, since you are not under law, but under grace. What then? Are we to sin because we are not under law, but under grace? By no means. Do you not know that if you present yourselves to anyone as obedient slaves, you are slaves to the one whom you obey, either of sin, which leads to death, or of obedience, which leads to righteousness? But thanks be to God that you who were once slaves of sin have become obedient from the heart to the standard of teaching to which you were committed, and, having been set free from sin, have become slaves of righteousness. I am speaking in human terms because of your natural limitations. For just as you once presented your members as slaves to impurity and to lawlessness, leading to more lawlessness, so now present your members as slaves to righteousness, leading to sanctification. When you were slaves of sin, you were free in regard to righteousness. But what fruit were you getting at that time from the things of which you are now ashamed? By the end of those things is the end of those things is death. But now you have been set free from sin and have become slaves of God. The fruit you get leads to sanctification and its end, eternal life. For the wages of sin is death. But the free gift of God is eternal life in Christ Jesus our Lord. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be God. We can stand for gospel readings. Holy Gospel, according to St. Matthew, the 10th chapter. Glory to you, O Lord. This 12 Jesus sent out, instructed them, brother will deliver brother over to the death, and the father is child, and the children will rise against parent and have them put to death. And they will be hated by all for my name's sake. But one who endures to the end will be saved. When they persecute you in one town, flee to the next. For truly I say to you, you will not have gone through all the town of Israel before the Son of Man comes. Disciple is not above his teacher, nor servant above his master. It is enough for the disciple to be like his teacher, and the servant like his master. If they have called the master of the house Beelzebul, how much more will they magnify those this is ours? So have no fear of them, for nothing is covered that will not be revealed, or hid that will not be known. What I tell you in the dark, say in the light. What you hear whisper, proclaim on the house top, and do not fear those who kill the body, but cannot kill the soul. Rather fear in him who can destroy both soul and body in hell. Are not two sparrows sold for a penny, and not one of them will fall to the ground apart from your father, but even the hair of your head are all numbered. Fear not, therefore, you are of more value than many sparrows. So everyone who acknowledges me before men, I also will acknowledge before my Father who is in heaven. But whoever denies me before men, I will deny before my Father who is in heaven. This is the gospel of the Lord. This is our, we're going to do our Nicene Creed. I believe in one God,
Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible,
and in one Lord Jesus Christ,
the only begotten Son of God,
Lord,
begotten of his Father before all worlds, God of God, light of light, very God of very God, begotten, not made, being of one substance with the Father, by whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven
and was incarnate by the Holy Spirit
of the Virgin Mary and was made man and crucified also for us under Pontius Pilate. And he suffered and was buried. The third day he rose again according to the Scriptures and ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of the Father.
And he will come again with the glory to judge both living and the dead,
whose kingdom will have no end. And I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified, who spoke by the prophets. And I believe in one holy Christian and apostolic church. I acknowledge one baptism for the remission of the sins, and I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Thank you.
Good morning again. Message from today come according to our gospel reading this morning, Matthew the 10th chapters, beginning at verse 5. These 12 Jesus sent out, instructed them, go nowhere among the Gentiles and enter no town of Samaritans, but go rather to the lost sheep of house of Israel. And proclaim as you go, saying, the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Heal the sick, raise the dead, cleanse the lepers, cast out demons. You receive without paying, give without pay. Acquire no gold or silver or copper for your belt, no bag for your journey, or two tunics, or sandal, or staff. For the laborer deserves his food. And wherever town or village you enter, find out who is wealthy in it and stay with until you are deferred. As you enter the house, greet it, and if the house is wealthy, let your peace come upon it. But if it is not wealthy, let your peace return to you. And if anyone will not receive you or listen to your word, shake of the dust from your feet when you leave that house or town. Truly I say to you, it will be more bearable on the day of judgment for the land of Sodom and Gomorrah than for that town. Behold, I am sending you out as a sheep in the midst of wolves. So be wise and serpent and innocent of us doves. Be aware of men, for they will deliver you over to courts and plague you in their synagogues. And you will be dragged before government asking for my sake to be a witness before them and Gentiles. When they deliver you over, do not be anxious how you are to be speaks or what you are to say. For what you are to say will be given to you in the hour. For it is not who speaks, but the Spirit of your Father speaks through you. Brother will deliver brother over the death, and the father will, and father is child, and children will be raised against their parent. Have them put to death, and you will hate by all for my name. Sake, but the one who endures to the end will be saved. And when they persecute you in one town, flee to the next. For truly I say to you, you will have gone through all the town of Israel before the Son of Man come. Disciple is not above his teacher, nor servant above his master. It is enough for a disciple to lack his teacher and the servant lack his master. If they call the master of the house Beelzebul, how much more will they manglings those of his house? So have no fear of them, for nothing is covered that will not be raised, or hate that will not be known. What I tell you in the dark, say in the light, and what you hear whisper, proclaim on our stop. And do not fear those who kill the body but cannot kill the soul. Rather fear him who can destroy both soul and body in hell. Are not two spare soul for a penny, and one of them will fall to the ground apart from your father, but even heir of your here are numbers. Fear not, therefore, you are of more value than many spare. So and one acknowledge me before men, I also will acknowledge before my Father who in heavens. But whoever deny me before men, I will deny before my Father who is in heaven. This is the text. This is the commission to Lord to his disciple. It was very expedition that had been sent out on alone. He had planned that disciple will face many challenges to carry out mission. We see how carefully Jesus instructed them. This word that Jesus tell his disciples a clear implication for his follower in every generation. The message must be preached, but it has started with whisper. What I tell you in the dark, say in the light. And what I hear whisper, proclaim in the hour's top. Christ gave his message in quietness of being alone with his disciple, with his messenger. It is in darkness in the here that Christ gives a message to the messenger. Christ gave his message when the messenger get all alone and draw close to the Lord in praying and started the word. The message is urgent. It is to be proclaimed loud and clear for all who can hear. Jesus himself would go away by himself to pray. We are told in Luke chapter 6. In this day, he went out to the mountain to pray, and all night he continued in praying to God. So if Jesus needs to go off by himself to pray in order to be an effective minister, his minister today also need to go off by themselves to draw close to the Lord and in prayer and the study of his word, so that then can proclaim his word for all to hear. In verse 24 and 25, Jesus also warns his disciples that they are not above persecution. Disciple is not above his teacher, nor servant above his master. It is enough for a disciple to be like his teacher, and the servant is like his master. If they have called the master of the house Beelzebul, how much more will they mangling those of his household. No disciple above his master, no servants above the Lord, above his Lord. The Lord suffer persecution, so will the disciple. The disciple must expect persecution, for he shall be persecuted even if Lord was persecuted. If our Master and Lord has suffered persecution, so shall we. Why? He is our Master and our Lord. That is, we are his. We belong to him, and all that he stands for is what we are standing for. Whoever calls men to persecute him, the same is in us. They will persecute us for the same reason they persecute him. That is a purpose of persecution. The believer share in suffering of Christ. God said, it is enough. Let has done enough for the believer. He has extolled the believer to unbeliever high. The believer is now just like his master and his Lord. As Paul wrote in Romans chapter 8, God has accepted believer as equal to his own dear son. The Spirit him bear witness with our spirit that we are children of God. And if children, the heir or heir of God and fellow heir with Christ, whereby we suffer with him in order that we may also be glorified with him. What does this mean? It means that persecution is a privilege. When we persecute, we are walking in the highest and most notable way. Can you imagine? We are called by God's very own Son, the Master and Lord of this universe. To have God's very own Son as our Master and our Lord is the highest privilege imaginable, though it is high privilege to suffer for him. No higher call could come to a man. Christ called us to live rashly in a world that does not want rashness. The fact that the world reacts against us does not do away with our calling. It only erases our call and sets even higher. The evil behavior of the world shows just how precious and how great to be desired our higher call is. If we look at 26:27, our Lord said, "Do not fear persecutor. God will reveal the truth on the day of judgment to be known to everyone. So have no fear of them, for nothing is covered that will not be revealed or heard that will not be known. What I tell you in the dark, say in the light. What you hear whisper, proclaim on the housetop." Apostle Peter, one of the 12 apostles that Jesus sent out, one who understand when much persecution, wrote in 1 Peter chapter 5, "Cast all anxiety on him because he cared for you. The Lord will redeem us because he cared for us from the beginning and blessing us." Christ is pointing out that God is fully aware of need of his dear children. God knows, oversees all events and happening on earth. Just as he knows all about the little sparrow, he knows when single sparrow fall to the ground. He knows every arrow person is hit. God is able to control the persecution. He can deal with it. There is no need for the believer to fear. God's love and care are our hopes in this world. God cares about every hurt inflicts upon us believer by persecutor. We should not be afraid and put our trust in God's love and care. God is able to take all the injury and pain inflicted by the sins and shame of men and use it all for the good of the believer. God has given us a great and gracious cause to reach men for Christ. Today is an important day in the history of the Lutheran Church. It was on this day, June 25, 1530, that a group of Lutheran teachers and leaders present the Hochberg Confession to Emperor Charles V in August Hochbergs. German, the Hochbergs Confession was express of the belief of Martin Luther and his followers. People who risk their life for the sake of Christ. Article 4 of Hochberg Confession states, "It is taught among us that we cannot obtain forgiveness of sins and righteousness before God through our merit, works, or sanctification, but that we receive forgiveness of our sins and become righteous before God of grace, for the cry is sex through faith when we believe that Christ has suffered for us, and that for his sex our sins is forgiven and righteousness and eternal life are given to us. All what the loser taught was backed up with numerous passages of the scripture, yet the loser endured much persecution from their enemy. But God was faithful to them and protect them. And still today we proclaim the same gospel that first Lutheran taught and proclaimed. Today we still promise to protect us as we proclaim to the world what he whispered in our ear. We are served by God's grace shown to us in Christ through faith alone. What a great privilege it is to be the messenger of God's grace. Amen. The peace of God, which preserves all understanding, keep your heart and mind in Christ Jesus. Please place your offerings in the offering plate on the table in Nessex. Can you please bring those forward? Let us pray. Let us stand, yes. Almighty God, your mercy, your treasures, your people for Christ sakes, and give us your commands to guide our ways. Grant that we redeemed by his blood may do all he has spoken, set forth lever to make known the gospel of your kingdom, prepare the lever of all church workers, and that many people may hear, believe, and praise you, Lord, hear in your mercy. O Lord, turn the eye of all who makes cause and judge on to know that wisdom and strength to face care out their duty. Bless us with daily bread and give us wisdom and stewardship of your creation. Lord, in your mercy. Heavenly Father, your Son demands stand his power over sin by healing every disease and affliction, give being to in need, deliver your gracious will, Lord, in your mercy. O Lord, thought Moses, you call people to yourself, and from them you deliver up your own Son to be our Savior. By his suffering and death, he has redeemed us from our sins. By his resurrection, he has released us from the fear of death. Help us to live as your people, doing good for which we create, and pray with confidence the petition and supplication of our heart. Lord, in your mercy. into your hand, O Lord. We command all for whom we pray, trust in your mercy through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who live and reign with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, and now and forever. Amen. Yeah, we have seat. Oh, he's coming up. Insulation, okay. Father's coming, you can come up. I think you can sit.
This time we'll install our board of officers for 2023 and 2024, and they'll come forward at this time.
I do.
And now address the parish, the Beloved and Lord, you heard the promise of the faithfulness spoken by these men and women whom you have selected to serve as officers of the Redeemer. Please turn the face of the congregation. You promised to support them in their work, remember them in your prayers, to work with them to the best of the abilities that God has given you, that he may be glorified his work begun in our midst. If so, then answer, we do. Can you face me again? Brothers and sisters in Christ, I saw you as office of the Redeemer, in the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Almighty, most merciful God, enlighten and strengthen you in your offices, that you may be good and faithful stewards to the glory of the saints and good of his people. Amen. Let us pray. Lord God, Heavenly Father, we give thanks you've raised up these servants to work among your people. We humbly implore you to grant them by your Holy Spirit those gifts needed for the faithful carrying out of their tasks. Most especially wisdom, strength, and willing hearts. Let your blessing rest on this congregation. Strengthen the faith, quicken the love, and enkindle the zeal of its members. That your name may be glorified in here and in all places under heaven, the kingdom of your Son may be advanced. Remember with thanksgiving those who faithfully served your people and now completed their time of service. We pray that in the end of days, be with all your faithful people. May hear the voice of Christ saying, come, you are blessed by my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Go in the name of the Lord. Be steadfast, immovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. Knowing that in the Lord your labor is not in vain. The Almighty and most merciful God, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless and preserve you. Amen. Go in God's peace. Go in God's peace. God's peace. Go in God's peace. Go in God's peace. God's peace. Go in God's peace. God's peace.
Yeah, we got to go back to our service. Thank you. Serve of sacraments. Yeah, we can stand. The Lord be with you. Lift up your heart. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly good, right, and solidarity, even more praising you and saying, Lord is prayer, all our Father, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. This is the word that our Lord spoke. Our Lord Jesus Christ, on the night that he was betrayed, took a bread, and when he had it, gave it thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciple and says, take it, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remember of me. In the same way, he also took the cups. And when he gave it, he gave it thanks and said to them, and saying, drink it all of you. This cup is the New Testament in my blood, which is shed for you. Do this so often as you drink it, in remember of me. Peace of the Lord be with you always. Amen. So we have said. So if you want to come, everyone sing that. So that's mine. I can. Take this and eat. This is my body. This is my blood. Welcome to the Lord's table. Take and eat, this is my body. 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 Take and eat. Take and eat, this is my body. Take and eat, this is my body. Take and eat, this is my body. Text and hate, this is my body. Text and hate, this is my body. Welcome to the Lord's table. This is my body given for you. 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 Take and eat, this is my body. This is my body. This is my body is given for you. Take and eat, this is my body. Yeah.
Bruce.